If you're new to the channel, welcome. If you're not new, welcome back. Today we are continuing on with our filament packages series or plugin series, whatever you want to call it. We're just basically messing around with some plugins and seeing how to integrate them. The one that I want to work on today is the activity log plugin. What that's going to do for us is whenever something changes in one of our models, then we can see who did it and who did what, just sort of monitoring what's going on with our different models. And the model that I'm going to be using to demonstrate that is the user model. If we head over to the filament documentation and we go to the plugins tab, you'll want to scroll down until you get to the search bar. We're going to type in activity. Now that's pulled up three different plugins that we could potentially use. They're all essentially built on top of the Spatie activity log that was built for Laravel itself. These are just plugins that were built on top of that package to be used with filament. The one that I've decided to use was this one here, and it is actually called Spatie Activity Log. If you click it, we're going to go to that, and it's going to bring you to this page right here. This was created by Alex Justison for filament, and again, it's just saying it's using the Spatie Laravel Activity Log package. In the installation instructions, you just require it. You can publish the config file. You can ingest different fields within the config file. We'll take a look at that a little bit later. Something that it does is it registers a filament activity resource, which if you want to override that, you can as well. You can customize the group, the sorting, all that good stuff. Let's just go ahead and go over to the GitHub repo. In the repo, we can just scroll down a bit and start grabbing some of these commands so that we can install it. I'll head back, I'll open up the terminal, paste that in, and I need to add sales since that's what I'm using. Great, let's go ahead and grab the command for publishing the configuration file. Let's go ahead and take a look at that file. It is registering the filament resource, the Alex Justison Filament Spatie Activity Resource, and we can create our own resource. This is the one that's coming from the vendor folder, which is fine, but we're going to go ahead and create our own. What we can do is continue on, and then in the config file, we're going to, in this field right here, we're just going to add our own. If we go down to customizing the activity resource, all we really have to do is to create the resource and then extend that activity resource coming in from the vendor folder. Now for us, all we really need to do is mimic what's going on in the vendor folders. If we head down to the vendor folders here and go to the Alex Justison folder and the Filament Spatie Laravel activity log, if we go down to the source folder, you'll see that we have a resources folder in here with the activity resource. You have a list activity, view activity, and the activity resource, the actual resource, right? So we can mimic something like this. We don't actually need the view. We're only really going to be working on the list activities so that we can see it in a table format. So let's go up. We'll close all of these. And we'll do sale artisan or PHP artisan if that's what you're using. Make filament resource, and we'll do activity resource. Great. Let's see. If we open up the app folder, filament folder, resources, let's start with the activity resource here. And this is pretty much what we're going to be doing. But in order to override the activity resource, pretty much here what we're working with is the activity model that's coming in from the vendor folder. So I don't want to use that one. I'm going to import the actual one. And if we head down a little bit, you can see we have edit action, delete action. I'm just going to leave those for right now. We're not really going to be using those, and we'll just leave it like that for right now. So let's see if we can register this new resource in the activity log. So here we're going to do app HTTP. No, sorry. App filament. Get rid of all the rest of this, and we'll keep it resources, activity resource. So let's go to the browser and see what we have now. As you can see, it has registered a new activities link, and of course we don't have any migrations or anything for this activity log. Now, in the documentation, it doesn't actually tell you that you need to migrate any tables or anything like that, but if you go to the Spatie's activity log from which it comes, it does say PHP Artisan Migrate in it, so we know that there are some migrations for this. So to find them, we can do vendor publish. And what this will do is it'll just print out a bunch of the config files that we could potentially use, right? So if we go to somewhere where it would say filament Spatie activity log. So this is it right here. You see the command that we used for the config file is right here. But if we go up a bit more, you see that there is another one that says activity log migrations. And this one is number 27. So we can actually use that information to get our migrations for this activity log package, which the migrations are really coming from the original Spatie activity log package. So we'll go ahead and take a look. And as you can see here, we have three. We'll open them each up and we'll take a look at them. So the first one here is to create activity log table. We'll have a log name, a description, subject, causer. This is all information relevant to what we're going to need for the user model. So we'll close that one. We also have an add event column to the activity log table. And this is just pretty much connecting the databases and getting that sorted for us with an event. Then in here, it's a batch UID column, not really relevant to what we're doing, but it is another migration that we can use. So for us, what we can do is do sale artisan migrate. So now you see we have no records found. There's no table or anything in here. We haven't filled any of that out yet. Let's go and take a look and see how we can handle getting some information in here just to have something to look at. The first thing that we're going to want to do is activity resource in the list actions. We can actually comment this out because we're not going to be needing it. And then also in the activity resource, instead of deleting them, I'm just going to comment them out as well. But what we can do in our activity resource, I can close these. We're not using them anymore. For our table, we can actually enter some fields in here first. Now, the first one that we can do, we can grab an ID. So we'll do text column, make ID, and then we can do the same thing. And instead of ID, we'll have causer ID, because that's the field in the database now, one of our new ones from the migrations that we just created. And then something that we can do too is create a label, and we'll just say logged by. This will give us the user ID who actually made this change. Copy this one. And here we can put description. We can actually also do causer type, and the label that we can make for that is model, and this will tell us which model this activity was registered by. I'm going to copy this one. And in this one, we can do properties. And I'll just call this one attributes for the label. And then we can also make a created at field from the database. For the label, we'll say logged at. Whenever the activity resource has been added in here, this created at field will be in here. So we'll say logged at. And then we can do date time. And we'll just register it as a date, the month, and the year. Now, since we don't actually have any information in the database as of yet, we can go ahead and create a seeder, just so that we can seed some info into the database. Down to the database, seeders. And in here, all I want to do is a for loop. This we're going to do to from 0 to 10. It's going to increment. And then just for now, one of the functions that we can use is activity. We're going to log it, and we're going to log the actual value. Now, these functions are actually coming from that base Spatie activity log package. If we go to the Spatie's package, you see there's an installation and setup section. And everything is migrated. You can publish the config files. Here's the config file that comes with that particular package that we have overrided to use with Filament. That's what our plugin is doing. If we go to the basic usage right here, this is how this package is being used. Now, this information isn't in the package that we have. This is a good resource to see what it's using to do all of that, right? So you can do activity all last. It'll return the last logged activity. You can have the description. That's where all this information is coming from. In this documentation, there are different ways to do different things. These are the functions that we use for stuff like caused by, and then the user model performed, you know, basically the same things that we're doing now, except it's coming from this package. So right now, what we can do is in the database seeder. So in here, we're going to remigrate everything. So I'm going to highlight all of this. I'm going to put some brackets around it. And then we'll do activity seeder. So let's go ahead and migrate this and see what we get. Okay, let's go back and check the browser. As you can see, we have an ID. We don't have a description or anything. We just kept our cedar really simple just so that we can see what's going on because we're not associated with any particular model at this time. So let's go ahead and handle that part of this. All we need to do is open up the user model because that's what I want to work on. Before I forget, we need to import the trait that's coming from this package. We can go ahead and use the trait dogs activity. Go ahead and import it. And it's coming from the Spatie activity log traits logs activity from the vendor folder. Okay, we'll go ahead and head down. And then under the last entry here, we can do public function. And the name of the function that we're going to be using is get activity log options. And it is using the log options as a return type. And then we can just return log options. We're going to set the defaults. And one of the things that we can do is to just log only. We don't want to keep grabbing a bunch of different things, just stuff that could potentially change. For us, we can say name as the first one, email, and is admin. These are fields all within our user model. We can also log only the dirty, meaning logging only what has been changed or only rows where things were actually changed. Then we can also do don't submit empty logs. These are all coming from the Spatie's activity log package. That should be good. We have it imported. So now these should be the new fields that we get from the database. So let's go ahead. We're going to deactivate that cedar that we created to put information in here. We're going to go ahead, reseed, and then we're going to re-log in and see what we get. Now we've been seeded with the description, the attributes. These are things that we put in our table to sort of demonstrate. And if you look at the attributes, well, we'll fix something like this. We'll be able to go see the page. But you can see that the attributes that we're getting from it is the name, the email, and whether or not the isAdmin is 0 or 1. Why don't we try to go ahead and change a user? We'll just do this user right here. We'll go ahead and change their name to, let's say, 111 isAdmin. And then we'll also change the email since those are the fields that will log in our activities table. They've been changed here. Let's go ahead to the activity. We'll go down to the bottom. And as you can see, logged by user number 2. So that's me as admin logged in. You see that our description is now updated. That's the event that happened. The model is the user model right in here. And as you can see, the old test name, the email, this was everything that was originally there. And then it has been changed and updated to name, test111, email. All that stuff that we put in the user model for this log function is the stuff that we're able to see here. Why don't we go ahead and create a button so that we can view this in a little bit more of a user-friendly format. Filament has a way where we can generate a resource, generate a view on an existing resource. Let's close these out. I'll close this out as well. And that we already have a resource already set up. And even if we open up the activity resource folder, we can see the pages that we have here, but we don't have any view activities. So something that we can do at this point, since we didn't generate it with it, we can do sale artisan, make filament page, we'll call it view activity. We're going to attach it to the activity resource. And then the type will just be view record. Now we need to register this new page in our get pages down here. So we can do it like this. I'll uncomment this one and then I'll remove this. This is going to change to view. This is going to be view activity. And then we don't need edit here. We can just leave it so that the record is injected into it. We can go ahead and also take a look. And as you can see, it's registering the activity resource from our filament folders, and that should be good. But we also want a button. So I'm going to go ahead and create one here. And this one will just be view action. Let's see if we can see that now. Let's go over. Now you can see we have a new view button and we have a new view page, but we don't have anything to display in there as of yet. For now, why don't we just go ahead? I'm just going to copy these because these really are the more important fields that we have. In the form up here, I'm going to use a card component. And then we'll do schema. Go ahead, paste that in. Now, instead of text column, we're going to do text input. And we can't actually use the date and time here. We'll change that in a minute, but I just want to see what we have here. Okay, very cool. So as you can see, we have an attribute row. And I want to make this two columns. So I'm going to use also, I'm going to use the grid component. And I'm going to make it have two in the grid column. And now we can just grab this and move it up a bit. So let's go and see what that looks like now. Okay, very cool. Something that we do need to add is the attributes. So instead of attributes, I'm probably going to do something a little bit different. We're going to do the name, the email, and the isAdmin. For these fields, we can actually chain on some things. So instead of this, I'm going to put old name as the label. And then for the properties, I'll do old name. And then for the new name, we'll do attributes name. And here I'll just put new name. If you're wondering where I'm getting this from, if you haven't yet and you're using Livewire, I highly suggest to use the Livewire dev tools because they are very, very helpful. And if you are used to using Vue, then the Vue dev tools, it's almost the exact same thing, but for Livewire. I've opened up the Livewire dev tool. I went down to the activity resource pages, and this is the page that we're on. And if you open it up, there's a data property here that has a list of all the different things that are coming from that database. Here's a properties folder, attributes. This is the email. This is all of the current stuff. And then there's an old folder with the old stuff. If we refresh this, then we should be able to see that name that we just did. We're going to be able to see the old and the new name. So we have old name, new name. Fantastic. Let's go and work on the other fields. So this one is going to be email. And then we'll do the same thing for isAdmin. I'll just say old isAdmin. It's really fine. It's not that serious. You see old name, new name, old email, old isAdmin, and new isAdmin. Why don't we also do the created at date and the updated date. So we'll change these titles. Here we can just do updated and updated. We don't really need the ats here. Very cool. Let's also change this formatting. Filament has a component that you can use and we can just use it here. So it'll be date, time, picker. And this will just format it for us, right? So let's go ahead and import this and see what that looks like. Nice. So we also have a little calendar here. But every field, if you didn't notice, every field in this form that we're using on this view page, they're all disabled. So you can't actually edit anything in here, which is perfect for our needs. We don't want anyone to be able to go in and just change stuff in here. We want them to go to the users table or whatever table that we set up, and we want them to change it there so that we can log it and we can see what's going on in here. Now, before anyone asks me, you can't really attach the user name. Don't know why I wasn't able to do that in the relationship. I couldn't chain on anything to bring it in, but I'm sure you clever people will figure out a way to do it. And if you do, just put it down in the comments so that you'll be able to help other people as well. If you're enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button as it really does help out the channel. Here's a video YouTube thinks you'll like, and here's a playlist to follow along. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.